is Darla Scrooby.
And this is DeWayless
Scrooby, happy holiday report.
First off in the news, we have the finalists for the OKKK Christmas Yard Display Contest. We all been waiting on this one.
We have.
Leading the finalists as usual is the home of W.H. and Vera Karp. This year, the Karp's Yard Display is entitled the Christmas Hall of Fame and will consist of a traditional nativity scene complete with live sheep. The Holy Family is shaped out of hard plastic lit from the inside, and they are surrounded not only by the wise men and shepherds, but the crowd also concludes with Santa Claus, Bing Crosby, the Grinchy Stole Christmas, and Natalie Wood. Still in the running is D.D. Snavely with her gigantic Christmas tree constructed out of aluminum pie pans and colored floodlights.
Oh, yes.
Entitled, Oh, What a Heavenly Latch.
You can see it as far off as Dewey County.
It draws bugs in December.
It does.
The older heat it puts out is awful. And still in the thick of the competition is the controversial entry over at the duplex of I Need a Good One and Hell in Bed. Their entry is entitled All I Want for Christmas and consists of two life-size cowboy mannequins stuffed into huge Christmas stockings hanging off the front porch balcony. A lot of folks were upset by that one.
Yeah. Sheriff Gibbons tried to arrest Anita and Helen.
He thought he had a double homicide.
He did. Let's see. Next up. Oh, the local chapter of the Smut Snatchers of the New Order is offering a $50 reward and an autographed copy of the Reverend Spike's new book, Cleaned Up Deuteronomy, for any information leading to the arrest of the infamous Christmas Phantom. The Phantom, as we all know, has wreaked havoc over the greater Tuna area for years. Turns out the Phantom struck again last night when he went and loosened all the light bulbs on the community Christmas tree, just ruining the big moment before Garland the Crump was to sing Oh Holy Night.
She's still not over the
hurt.
She's not.
So if you have any information on the Phantom, you be sure to give Vera Karp a call over at the Smut Snatchers of the New Order. She's down there running the organization while she waits for the Reverend Spax to get out of prison. Next up, on a somber note, the Coweta Baptist Church, in conjunction with the Drop Back and Punt Club, is conducting a 24-hour prayer vigil for head football coach Raymond Chasey as he tries, for the third time, to pass the Texas Teacher State Competency Exam. That says here, if he flunks it again this time, he's going into politics. Get on down there to Coweta Baptist Church and pray, pray, pray.
Well, Arliss, you don't know what you've got till it's gone.
You don't. We'll have more on that story as it develops. But now it's time for the public opinion section of our show, Tuna Speaks. And this week's concerned citizen is none other than, none other than Tuna's own, Elmer Watkins. Elmer?
This is Elmer Watkins from Clan 249, inviting all y'all to our annual Christmas Family Fun Night and Skeet Shoot. The theme of this year's Family Night is the widest Christmas ever, and it consists of fun and education for the whole family. We'll wear something white and win a raffle ticket for our door prize, a butane-powered flamethrower. After last year, I must remind y'all of our new rule prohibiting flammable liquids where women and children are present. I feel very personal about this issue. You would too. All your eyebrows had burnt off. You never grew back. That's why I wear my cap so low. It's embarrassing. This is Elmer Watkins from Clan 249 saying, season's greetings.
Yeah. Thank you, Elmer. No. Horrible person. I tell you folks, it sure is a joy to be here in the greater Tuna area when the spirit of Christmas just reaches out and grabs a hold of you. It is.
Tell you, it's me all choked up inside.
Hell, you've always been emotional.
I have.
He has. Next up, the local theatrical scene, the much-troubled production of A Christmas Carol by Charlie Dickens, will go on as scheduled, according to artistic director Joe Bob Lipsig. Joe Bob, as we all know, has become somewhat of a local legend for his innovative staging techniques, which gave us last year's unforgettable Greek tragedy of Medea, set in Yazoo, Mississippi, in which Medea's husband dumps her for a waitress from Cincinnati, forcing her to strangle her children rather than have them grow up with the Yankee stepmom.
That Joe Bob is a great fellow.
He is. It says here that Christmas Carol is going to be a traditional staging this year, and that all financial contributions are going to go towards paying the theater's overdue electric light bill. City Secretary Dixie DeBerry says if they don't pay it by Christmas Eve, they'll be singing in the dark.
Well, you know what it is, Arliss. She's still upset about last year's musical. Joe Bob said she was too old to play Mame.
Hell, she's older than water.
She is.
She is about half as mean, too. Remember that time when she turned off the lights at the homecoming football game right before halftime?
That poor little twirler had her baton up 30 feet in the air.
She did. Caught it right below the eye. Oh, it's gotta hurt. Let's see, Thurston, you got that farm report?
Yeah, it's around here someplace. I don't know where the damn thing is. Ronnie! I hate it when I have to make it up. I know that cantaloupes were higher than a city skirt the other day. Some we're not supposed to eat. Oh! Hell, here it is. It says here, beef unchanged, pork unstable, and chicken uneventful. And there's not a thing on here about sow bellies, so they just go to a commercial break from our sponsor, D.D.'s Navely of D.D.'s Used Weapons. Merry Christmas, D.D.
And a holly jolly Christmas to you too, Thurston. This is D.D. Snavely asking you, do you know how dangerous it can be in this day and age to ride unarmed in a one-horse open sleigh? Well, lay your fears to rest, because D.D.'s this season is stocked to the ceiling with weaponry for the car, the home, and the workplace. God forbid that any of you listeners should fall victim to Christmas theft. Wouldn't you rather shoot someone than watch them run off with your new toaster? I know I would. So whether it's a stun gun, judo clubs, or just a good old-fashioned switchblade, when you come down to D.D.'s, you'll have a holly jolly Christmas, and the criminal will have a silent night.
Thank you, D.D. Now, folks, if you can't be with your family this Christmas, or if your loved ones are just driving you right up the wall, plan on coming down to the OKKK Christmas Party Covered Dish Supper. It's a good time.
Hell, I have been every year since Trudy and I got divorced, and I've never had a better Christmas.
You know, I kind of miss old Trudy.
Oh, I miss Trudy, too. Like a rash.
Now, Arliss, where is your Christmas spirit?
Do not get me started. You know it's because of Christmas that Trudy and I got divorced.
Oh, that's right. I forgot.
Yeah, she wanted a set of them Japanese steak knives, and I got her a heating pad instead.
And that's when she poured all that grapefruit juice in the Christmas punch?
Sure is. She knew I was allergic to grapefruit juice before she went and poured God knows how much of it in the punch.
I remember it sure made you itch.
Itch? I was scratching so hard, the doctors made me wear mittens. I still had them on in divorce court.
He did.
I did.
Trudy.
Trudy, if you can hear my voice, you're too close. You're too close! Yes, sorry about that. Let's see, next up. Oh, from our world news desk. Christmas violence continues with no end in sight, leaving thousands homeless in Mozambique. Hell, I can't pronounce the name of this place.
Mozambique.
That must be way off.
Must be, folks. They must be foreigners, so never mind.
Never mind. This is Thurston Willis.
And this is Arliss Drewby saying happy holidays.
Society. I'd like to encourage all of you who are looking to acquire Christmas pets this season not to succumb to the urge to acquire exotic animals, because after a few weeks, the new wears off and, well, I end up with them. You may think it's cute to teach barroom language to that minor bird, but when your fundamentalist relatives come over to visit and it wakes them up at dawn cussing a blue streak, what do? You give them to me. That baby alligator may be a family favorite when he's no longer than your finger, But then 10 months later, when he's hissing at your sister-in-law and trying to mate with your luggage, what do? You give them to me. Wild animals have mean streaks, and I've got the stitches to prove it. Skunks are moody, raccoons are self-centered, and wild hogs have a zero success rate as yard pets. So just say no to wild animals. If nothing else, it'll cut down on your doctor bill. Like my grandma used to say, you just give nature its space and it won't try and kill you. This has been Petey Fisk speaking to you from the Greater Tuna Humane Society. Thank you.
Doing for Joe Bob can wait. He's never missed a meal for you
or anybody else from the look of things.
Guilty too if that old Philistine Dixie D-Berry was threatening to cut off your lights, and you were only the most brilliant director that ever lived. So don't knock Joe Bob, Mother. He's the only sensitive person in this hole in the road, and if he moves back to Lubbock, I'll just kill myself, so there!
Charlene! Baptists do not kill themselves!
I'll start a new trend.
Honey, how is play practice?
Awful, thanks to you and those goofy old smut snatchers. Whoever heard of a dirty word in Christmas Carol?
Well, Vera Karp says they're there. The smut snatchers are here for everybody's protection. Censorship is as American as apple pie, so shut up. Oh, and honey, I want you to stick around the house today. I want to get the whole family together to take a picture for next year's Christmas cards. That is, if I can get your daddy here long enough to sit still for one.
I know what. Next time Daddy comes home and passes out drunk in front of the TV, how about we all gather around the couch and take a picture of that?
Charlene!
Put that look pretty on a Christmas card.
Charlene, don't make me slap you this near Christmas. Now come over here and help Mama decorate the tree.
That is a sick tree. Connie Karp's tree touches the ceiling and has icicles that look like real ice.
Well, Connie Karp's family has more money than we do. Charlene, stop throwing the icicles. Charlene? Why don't you hang up this little angel? You remember when you made that?
Ew, I never made that. You say that every year.
Well, I'm gonna hang it up right here next to Stanley's little Latin's plate. You remember when he made that in reform school? I wish you would help me. It is no fun decorating a tree by yourself.
You know, I always wonder why Joe Bob has never been married.
Well, honey, I don't think Joe Bob is the marrying kind.
Why?
Joe Bob has always been different.
What is that supposed to mean?
Well, it just means he's out of the ordinary.
You are so cruel.
Honey, you know I like Joe Bob. Now come over here and help Mama with the icicles. It'll be fun.
I don't want him. And besides, I'm not going to waste my artistic integrity on that pathetic little shrub.
Charlene, you have 5 seconds to get in the Christmas spirit before I hairlip you.
Now go on. Fine. Happy?
Charlene,
happy?
Stop throwing the icicles. You get that meme that's from your daddy.
Speaking of meme, will you tell Stanley to rinse out the tub? I get totally grossed out every morning.
Stanley, you be nice to Stanley. He has a lot on his mind.
That's impossible.
Today is the last of his probation. That is a Christmas blessing.
It would be a Christmas blessing if you were back in jail.
He is nervous enough about playing that part in a Christmas carol.
I don't know why. He just stands there like he's in some kind of lineup. Everybody knows he's the Christmas Phantom, and it's just a matter of time before he's back in prison.
He was in reform school. Your daddy was in prison.
It's the same thing.
Today is the last of his community service. I think you ought to show your twin brother some support.
It would be a community service if he left town.
Stanley's not going anywhere.
That's not what I hear.
And where do you think you are going?
I don't have to tell you everything.
Fine. You just stay gone all day, young lady, and I'll lock you out there with the dogs, and Joe Bob Lipsy can feed you.
Thank you, Joe Crawford.
Hello? Hello, Ike. Nice of you to call me back. Well, you might not want to wish me a Merry Christmas when you hear what I have to say. Yeah, listen, Ike. I want you to have my husband call his home. You don't know where he is? Well, I suggest you finish your Christmas brew, get off your Christmas butt, and find him! Oh, I think you'll find him all right, Ike. Because if you don't, the next person I'm going to leave a message with will be your wife, Ida. You remember Ida? And I'm going to tell her all about that red-headed bank teller that you and Leonard and my husband and half the men in this town play poker with in Sand City. Now, I'm mad enough, Ike, that I had to leave a message in this nasty beer joint you're in. I'm going to spray this phone down with Lysol when I hang up. But if my husband does not call his family this afternoon, I'm cashing in his poker chips and yours. Now, you try to have a merry one. I'm a desperate woman. Stanley, Jean, get down here now! You brought this on yourself.
Damn, Mama! Your main street sure shows itself at Christmas time, you know that?
It didn't used to. Everyone has called here this morning except your daddy, so stop complaining. Charlene's bad enough. Oh, and Jody's in the pantry with a mean pregnant pussycat ready to bingo in a minute now. If Santa Claus walked through that door right now, I would set his beard on fire.
Great. That's just what we need, a cat. A little foul, moody, tempered thing with claws that sheds. Hell, we got that with Charlene.
Stanley, stop slandering your sister.
Actually, a cat is a step up.
Have you gotten your sister anything for Christmas?
No, they were all out of sheep dip.
Well, I got you something for her and Stanley. I hope no one we know has anything to do with this Christmas phantom business.
I have been at play practice every time the phantom struck, so just lay off, Mama. I've got an airtight alibi.
That is what worries me.
You are just like everybody else in this town. I try to be so nice to people, and they treat me like
Stanley, damn it! Do not swear on Christmas! Oh, and that was real nice of you hiding your Aunt Ruby's new glass eye.
I put it where she could find it.
In the refrigerator?
Well, she shouldn't have left it on the TV stand. I couldn't even watch Soul Train without that thing staring back at me.
Do not let your father catch you watching Soul Train.
Doesn't even look like her good eye.
Well, she got that eye on discount. You know, she's always been frugal.
She's always been cheap.
Stanley, stop talking about the eye before I throw myself off a water tower.
Stanley, I do not want to argue with you. I do enough of that with your daddy.
Why don't you leave him?
I do not want to talk about divorce on Christmas.
He doesn't let you play bingo.
Gambling is a sin.
Never takes you to the movies.
They haven't made a good movie since Audie Murphy died.
Did you get that microwave you wanted last year? No.
I changed my mind. Your Aunt Ruby got one of those and all her body hair fell off.
Never mind, Mama.
Stanley, I just want to try and have a decent Christmas. Here, this is your present for Charlene. It's that new cologne, Compromise. I just want you to wrap it up and put it under the tree.
Great, Mama. What were you thinking? Have you smelled the bathroom?
Well, I just can't do anything, right?
We gotta tell Charlene it's not deodorant. She lays it on like a crop duster. What do you want for Christmas, Mama?
Your father here.
What's your second choice?
He might show up.
Do not eat the eyes off those clown cookies. They're for the MYF.
When did we turn Methodist?
We didn't. I'm just getting a little extra spending money. Oh, and Stanley, your Aunt Pearl called. She wants you over there. Something about a banny rooster and a blue jay.
They still going at it?
Stanley, do not drink out of the carton. And please, don't go to your last probation meeting looking like a zombie. Wear a shirt and tie.
I don't own a tie.
Come here.
Why?
Just come here. I want you to hold this.
Wait, why am I holding this up? Oh, damn it, Mama, I wish you'd warn me before you do that.
Well, at least I have one picture of you at Christmas time. Stanley, why don't you hang around the house just for a little while and help your mama with the icicle?
It looks like Charlene already did. Hell, it looks like baby Jane had to go at it.
Don't you want to be here when we put the star on top of the tree?
Oh, take a picture.
Take a picture? Take a picture? What is wrong with this family? Christmas used to be so special. Now it's every man for himself. Can't even get my family together to take a picture. It's not fair. Well, I guess the good Lord has other plans for us. Still, I think I deserve a little peace on earth. Hello?
Bertha?
Hello, Vera.
Bertha, what are we going to do about this Christmas phantom? He's in every house on the block but mine.
I haven't thought about it much, Vera. We don't have a yard display.
Hang on. Lupe? Lupe, darling? Hang that on the lower branch. Vajalo, Lupe. Bring it down. Ba-ja? Oh, are you there?
Yes, Vera.
Well, the phantom can't be your Stanley. He's been at play practice with Virgil, so apparently he has an alibi. But if he does turn out to be the phantom, Lord, I pray they don't throw him in jail until after Christmas. You've been through so much, how do you hold up?
I'm used to it.
Oh, and about Stanley's probation, I baked him a cake. But if he does mess up, we'll just throw that cake in the freezer and have it after he gets out.
You've always been so thoughtful, Vera.
Oh, it's no trouble at all. We have those Superply freezer bags. I can't remember the name. Hang on. Lupe! Lupe, darling! Where are El freezer bags? Freezer bags. Freezer bags? Oh, Lord, sometimes it's like a scene from the miracle worker around here. I just remember why I called you. I know what's wrong with your Christmas tree.
What?
Put on a pot of coffee and I'll be right over.
Oh, no, Vera.
No, it's no trouble at all. I'm right across the street.
You don't... Lord, this Christmas is gonna take 10 years off me. One child in the pantry with a pregnant cat, another with 1 foot in jail, and Charlene's in love with a sissy. Lord, I wish that Joe Bob would go back to Beaumont or Corpus or wherever it is he goes, take his movie posters and his Broadway soundtracks with him. If I have to listen to Bally High one more time, I will throw Charlene out in the street. And now, Vera Carp is coming over to redecorate my Christmas tree.
Knock, knock.
Come in, Vera.
Oh, you have such a lovely view of my yard display from here.
Yes, we do.
Oh! Oh? Uh-huh. 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 I know what's wrong with your Christmas tree.
What?
You just have to turn the bad side to the wall.
We did.
Oh. Well, I know what. I'll give you some of our old ornaments to fill in those bare spaces in the back. I gave them to Lupe, but I'll make sure she brings them back. She doesn't appreciate nice things.
Vera, did you complete the dirty words list for A Christmas Carol?
Of course I did. I'm the head of the obscene committee, remember?
What's the verdict?
Well, merry gentlemen have to go.
Merry gentlemen? Why?
Oh, Bertha. You know those people speak in code.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, and there has just been a storm of controversy about round young virgins.
Vera, that's round yawn virgin.
Oh. Well, it's too late. They're already out. I'm not comfortable singing about virgins in the first place. We'll leave that to the Catholics. I have just been an overheated downhill wreck about this Christmas yard display. If we win again this year, we'll have to retire the trophy.
I know how much it means to you, Vera.
Oh, the trophy is so lovely. It would mean so much to me personally to win 15 years in a row. Hang on.
Virgil! Virgil! Don't mess with the sheep and they won't bite!
Oh, they say ordinarily sheep aren't aggressive, but all three in my yard display have bitten Virgil.
I guess they've had enough.
Oh, I know how they feel. I have tried everything to keep him out of that yard display. Barbed wire, baling wire. Dee Snavely tried to sell me some of that stuff they use on the Mexican border. But Lord, that didn't even slow Lupe down. And she's afraid of the garage door opener.
Hang on. Virgil! Virgil! Don't grab the sheep there. That's why he charges.
Oh, Vera, you really ought to have him seen, too.
Oh, we'll have him sheared and slaughtered come New Year's. And as for Virgil, we're shipping him off to military school in No Hope, Arizona. Lord, I pray they can do something with him.
Well, Vera, I'm expecting Hank any minute now, so...
Well, you could just be waiting all day. Hang on.
Virgil! Virgil! Stop chucking rocks at the Holy Family. They've just been repainted. Put down that gravel. Behave.
Huh. Well, do you think Dixie DeBerry will shut off the lights on the community play?
Well, if they don't pay their bill, I'm sure she will.
Oh, Lord, it would be such a shame to have them go through all that work and have nothing happen. Mm-hmm. Ordinarily, WH and I would pay the bill. But, Lord, times are hard. We could barely afford to buy new cars this year. Hang on, he's got the baby.
Virgil! Virgil! Put down that baby! He's wired with electricity! You're going to get electrocuted! Put the baby down now!
Oh, I don't know how he got that baby out of the manger. I paid Julio minimum wage to glue that baby in. Oh, let me ring you later.
Oh. Bye, Vera! Good luck with the contest! Guess it's just you and me now, little tree. Let's see if we can't fix you up. Oh, Charlene did throw.
Stanley. Let's see. Move this hair. Get you up here. And one more. Right there. All right. That's got to look a little better. Lord, I just hope I can make it through this day. Shut up, Woofy. Get back. Oh, Arliss. Come on in. I'm sorry about him. I think that just means he likes you.
Yeah, I think if he liked me anymore, we'd have to get married. That's a cute little dog you got there, Bertha.
Oh, well, Chiquita's a little hyper.
Oh, I had one just like her when I was a kid. Little ping pong ball sized head, little marble eyes, shook a lot. Yeah, we took her to Yellowstone one year, and a hawk came and got her the first 10 minutes.
That is terrible. Oh, can I get you a cup of coffee?
Oh, actually, I just came by to see Hank. Somebody left his wallet down at the radio station.
Oh, where'd they find it?
Can't say as I recall.
Oh, Arliss, I'm used to Hank. You can tell me.
Well, as I recall, it was in a parking lot.
Parking lot of the Starlight Motel, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. I'm sorry.
I appreciate you bringing it by.
You know, if it makes you feel any better, I know how you feel. One time Trudy came home wearing Fruit of the Looms. Well, I got a lot of stuff to do for the party later tonight, but you come by the party if you feel like it, Bertha.
I just might do that.
Merry Christmas, Bertha.
Merry Christmas to you too, Arliss.
Lord, Christmas used to be so simple. Well, not always. I remember that year Hank got out of prison, and I was working over at the Tasty Cream, cooking on Christmas Eve. And there was that bread man from Odessa, just begging me to run away with him. He meant it, too. He'd been drinking, but I know he meant it. Where would you be now, Bertha? I wouldn't have my babies, and I wouldn't trade that for anything.
Mama! Mama! Mama!
Huh? Oh, no, not now, cat! Okay, honey, calm down. All right, Miss Kitty, no one's gonna bother you. Jody, reach up there and grab that cardboard box. Hurry, honey, we're gonna need it.
Come on in, Pearl. Come on in.
Merry Christmas, Didi.
Merry Christmas. Have a seat, have a seat. I've been meaning to call you, Pearl. How come you didn't do a yard display this year?
Oh, I am throwing in the towel, Didi. That Vera Cart wouldn't let go of that trophy if you sprayed her with mustard gas.
Well, maybe she will, maybe she won't. That giant Christmas tree of mine out there is going to be hard to top. You know, I thought you really had a contender with your Christmas at Colonel Sanders last year.
Oh, it took too long to get the chickens into their little elf costumes. Now, Didi, I'm here looking for a gun to buy.
I thought you had a gun.
Nope, I threw it out after I shot my second husband.
Was that the sleepwalker?
Well, he should have told me that.
Yeah.
I'm looking for something to kill blue jays with.
Pearl, have I got the gun for you? This is what they call a Canadian hummingbird derringer. It's light, easy to use, fits in your purse, and it'll blow the fuzz off a hat's ass at 35 yards.
I don't know, Didi. Maybe a gun's too loud. My hands won't
move. Oh, all right. Or! See if we got any more of that poison bird seed back
there. No, poison's out. I haven't used it since I killed Henry's bird dog. Oh,
never mind, RR. But while you're back there, make me a cup of hot chocolate and try not to scald the milk. Gow! Pitiful! Well, let me think.
Oh, Didi, there are snakes in your drawers.
Snakes? Oh, these are just rubber snakes, Pearl. Oh, hey, these are great for scaring off pests. Sprinkle a few of these babies in the yard, and the blue jays won't slow down till they hit Oklahoma.
I don't know, Didi. I can't be around anything that don't have feet.
Well, some people are funny that way. I guess the only thing left will be the old slingshot and ball bearing routine.
Oh, yes. And I could use those marbles I've had around the house for years.
Yeah.
I got them when Bertha's kids were little. Yeah. But Charlene swallowed so many, I had to put them away. I still got them, though.
That is smart, Pearl. That is smart. One person's clutter is another person's weapon. My mama always taught me that.
How is your mama? Dixie told me she tried to cut off all her hair.
Oh, hell, she did. Mama's going downhill every day. I tell you, it just damn near kills me. And then this morning, she pops out of bed and claims that she is the Christmas Phantom.
Oh, no.
Oh, it gets worse. She claims that you and Dixie Deberry put her up to it.
Oh, you better find a home for her quick.
Mine is the first thing to go, Pearl. Let me get her out here. She'd love to see you.
Oh, don't disturb Mimi.
Mama!
Don't disturb her.
Mama! Oh, Mama, now you're going to have to mop that up. Mama, Pearl Burris is here to see you. Pearl? Pearl Burris? Ah, never mind. I'll just... What? Where'd she go? Oh, well, I'll just put it on her belt. One slingshot. $150. Back to this pathetic tree. Regular grenades, patriotic grenades, America. This tree is so pathetic, it looks like RR is a tree. RR, you find him yet?
Find what?
The grenades, goddammit, that's what I sent you in there for.
Oh, no, I forgot, but I found those National Geographic.
Yeah, I'll bet. God, you're useless. You stand here. Keep your eyes open for customers. Do not cross this line. God, if you're a cat, I'd have you fixed.
Okay. Hell, I'm there. She shoots coyotes on sight.
Oh, Fresno's only half coyote, and I nearly turned him into a vegetarian.
Well, she shoots vegetarians too, so watch out.
Okay. Say, have you seen any UFOs lately?
Oh, no, none of the big ones. Hey, what happened to your finger?
I think Fresno regressed a little bit. He's a little low on protein. Say, do you sell mussels?
Oh, no. Deanie said they're white the shelf, Faith. What's the point
of having a cargo?
She's coming by.
Sorry.
She'll be right back.
Oh, it's okay. It's okay. Goodbye, RR.
Okay. Bye, Petey.
Now, where were we lying? That's right. Later, Nate.
RR! Get back into this mice and tear gas department. Put everything back in alphabetical order. God, this is no way to run a business.
I'm right on it, D.D.
And the mill's boiling over.
Uh-oh.
Girl, I said I was marrying the original missing link. But I wouldn't listen. Oh, well. It's too late now. Let's see. This tree needs some kind of topper. It's gotta be the lethal.
Hey, Diddy. How are you?
I was doing fine till just now. Whatever you want, we are out of.
You should have been a comedian, you know that.
I'll take that as a compliment coming from the town joke. You've been wagging that gun around for years and never put a notch on it. Yeah. You are an example of wasted tax dollars.
Well, what do you think about this? I'm here to requisition all your bookkeeping records and tax receipts.
No, don't tell me someone went and taught you how to read.
Now, I've been doing some undercover work looking for that Christmas phantom.
I'm not showing my records to nobody.
You might as well cooperate, Diddy. If I have to come back here, I'm bringing a subpoena.
If you think you're gonna go rooting around through my records, you better bring a Chinese dinner for six!
Damn it, Diddy! You make it damn hard for me to do my job.
Yeah! Get out of here! Oh, and if you're gonna go brooding around through my filing cabinets, you're gonna be scratching your ass with a stump for the rest of your life! Yeah. Getting kicked my chairs everywhere! This is my store. I am a strong woman.
Hey, now! You got a minute?
That depends, Ike, on what you're here to buy.
I always been a good customer, you know that.
Oh, yeah, I remember that time you bought a quarter's worth of BBs for that dim-witted kid of yours.
You never had any problems till I fed him all that plant food.
Right.
Listen, have you seen Hank Buemiller?
You know, Ike, I was in such a rush to get to work this morning that I forgot to check the gutters!
Now that ain't funny, Petey. I just got off the phone with Bertha, and if I don't find Hank, it is gonna be a blue Christmas for a lot of folks.
Boo hoo hoo! I repeat, are you here to buy anything?
Yeah, I'll be back to that later. Right now, I gotta find Hank.
Maybe you should ask Bertha. I see her parking her car across the street right now.
Adios, amigos!
You better find Hank Buemiller, or it's gonna be Vaya con Dios! Dee's use weapons. If we can't kill it, it's immortal. Oh, hi, Dottie. It's usually bad news when you call Dottie. What's wrong? You're playing late or something? What do you mean you're not coming? Why? Oh, great. Oh, hell, he's always had that. What, they don't have antifungal cream in California, Dottie? Well, you're still coming to get Mama. No. I hadn't heard last Christmas. Yes, I know you took her for Easter. She's still got egg food dye in her hair and under her nails and God knows where else. We can't even take her to church. Oh, yeah? Oh. Well, I got a Christmas wish for you too, Dottie. I hope that Santa comes and craps down your chimney. God, it's hell being a twin.
Hey, Deanie, you busy?
Oh, come on in, Pickles. Come on in. I am never too busy to talk to you. You want a cup of coffee?
Oh, I just thought you might have been frazzled with the last-minute rush.
Oh, business is always brisk when the Phantom's on the loose. You make sure to thank Stanley for me.
I hope to God the cops don't catch him.
Oh, Sheriff Gibbons couldn't catch a cold in the Klondike.
Now, Dee Dee, the real reason I'm here, I'm looking for a burglar alarm.
Nope, sorry. We sold out of those yesterday. You haven't...
A problem with prior work?
Oh, no, it's nothing like that. I just want something to wake me up when my worthless husband comes sneaking in late at night.
Hank out Tomcat again?
I tell you, it is hard to get by when the whole town knows my husband is as useless as ice trays in hell.
Do not get me started. RR's been on a wandering binge lately. I tell you, Bertha, I do not know how such well-brought-up gals like you and I could have married so badly.
It is a mystery.
Oh, and RR's drinking's only gotten worse. He wanders off so much, I decided I better find out something about safe sex.
Oh, Dee Dee, I swear.
Can you imagine how depressed I was when I found out that's what we've been doing the whole time?
Well, I suppose some things are better left unknown.
Amen and hallelujah.
Was that Ike Thompson I saw sneaking off?
It sure as hell was. There's another one about as useless as titties on a boar hog. Well, back to your Hank problem. You want me to order that burglar alarm?
Oh, no, don't bother. I'll just do what I've always done.
What's that?
Rearrange all the furniture and unscrew all the light bulbs.
Pickles, pickles, pickles. We sure knew what we were doing when we voted you class whip back in high school.
Well, sometimes you have to laugh to keep from crying.
Yeah.
Well, I better run. It'll take me a while to move that sofa.
Oh, all
Merry
right.
Christmas, Dee Dee.
Merry Christmas, Bertha. Oh, don't strain your back. I like that woman. Let's see what's on the radio. All right.
Stops up radio shopping spree.
Leonard.
Now, folks, I haven't sold anything in weeks. I'm so desperate, I'll take hot checks. Yeah. Where's your Christmas spirit? We've got great merchandise here. Come on now, give me a call.
Yeah, I'll give you a call, Leonard. Leonard? Dee Dee Snively. No, I didn't call you to buy nothing. I called to talk to you about that egg separator you sold me last March. You said it had a 10-month guarantee and it broke in 9.5. What do you mean you don't want to talk about it on the air? Well, maybe you'd rather talk about that red-headed bank clerk you go bowling with every other Friday night. Yes, I know your wife could be listening, and I hope to God she is. Can you hear me, Reba? Reba, can you hear me? Don't talk to me about ruining your Christmas, Leonard. My husband's a drunk who sees flying saucers. My mama's losing what's left of her mind. And my sister Dottie just had to call up and show her butt. My Christmas has already been ruined, Leonard. I thought I'd just bring up and ruin yours. I think I see Reba headed your way right now in her Land Rover. If I were you, Leonard, and I wanted to see Christmas in one piece, I'd start dashing through the snow. Dashing through the snow.
Sit down. I want to talk to you.
What is it, Pearl?
Oh, Stanley, I'm nervous. There was a white mule in my dream last night.
That's not a sign of death, is it, Pearl?
Oh, no. That's a white horse. A white mule is usually nothing more than car trouble.
Oh.
Still, I'd appreciate it if you'd look under the hood of that Pontiac before you go.
Oh, I sure will. You know who I dreamed about last night? You remember that weenie dog you had that could spell?
Oh, Doc, the Dash Hound.
Yeah.
Got him from Petey Fisk.
course, at the time, we didn't know he was a cat hater.
I've never seen anything like it. You just say the word cat, and he would go all wild.
Got so bad we couldn't say cat. We had to spell it, and he'd still go crazy.
He could spell cat.
Oh, we had a spelling dog.
Oh, whatever happened to that dog, Pearl?
Dog? Mildred Jean Perkins' cat killed him.
No. What was the name of that cat?
Itty Bitty.
Itty goddamn bitty. Who in their right mind would name a cat that size itty bitty?
That brain damaged child of theirs, Randy. That boy was not right in the head and they still let him name that cat.
How did itty bitty kill Doc?
Oh, she kind of rolled over in the street out there and lured old Doc under the wheels of a Lone Star beer truck.
Damn, it sure is a shame to lose a good dog like that. That can spell.
Oh, Stanley, it is a shame that you did not have your taxidermy license back then. You could have stuffed old Doc for us. That is the only way to have animals. Stuffed and hanging on your wall. You only have to dust them once a week.
And they don't keep you up at night.
You are so lucky to have a skill. You ought to leave, Tuna. Folks around here will just keep you looking back. You gotta go out there, tackle life. Don't be like me and throw away a skill.
I didn't know you had a skill, Pearl.
Oh, yes, I was a riveter back in Houston during the war.
A riveter?
The Japs never sank one of my ships. I put in so much overtime, my fillings just flew out. I had to quit. Stanley, has your daddy come home?
Hell, Pearl, daddy's never home.
Well, you make sure your mama has a good Christmas.
Oh, I got her a gift certificate down at the Conoco. 5 free oil changes.
Staying out of trouble is present enough.
Yeah.
Now, what do you want Santa Claus to bring you?
Bus ticket out of this black hole. I don't know, out west it'd be nice. Your friend Dixie DeBerry ain't making my life any easier.
How so?
Oh, she's making a big fuss down the little feeder.
Oh, how's that going?
Shh, Pearl, nobody knows their lines. Everyone's fighting like cats in a bag. Joe Bob is blaming the Phantom. He says the Phantom's got everybody so upset they can't think. And everyone's looking at me out of the corner of their eye. I tell you, Pearl, I've had it up to my ass with this sorry excuse for a town, and somebody's gonna pay.
Now, Stanley, don't lose your head.
Once I get off probation, I'm gonna go down to the 4-H barn and spray paint private parts on all the livestock. Let them hang a blue ribbon on that.
Now, you don't want to do that, Stanley.
I also got me a defanged rattlesnake that's gonna wind up in somebody's commode. I just haven't figured out whose yet.
And we'll keep them regular.
Sheriff Gibbons keeps following me around like a bird dog. Dang, he's determined to catch me doing something.
Buford Gibbons is loopy. Always has been. When he was a teenage boy, he wet the bed at church camp.
No.
It was terrible. They called him Rubber Sheets.
Oh, Rubber Sheets? Rubber Sheets Gibbons, yeah. I like the sound of that. Well, old Rubber Sheets ain't gonna catch me doing diddly. Once I get on done with that play, I'm gonna get even and then get the hell out of Dodge.
Oh, Stanley, I just had a revelation. If Dixie DeBerry cuts the lights off on that play, you won't be able to finish your probation. She has to extend. She just has to. That's the end of it. Oh, my God. I forgot about the Phantom.
The Phantom?
Never you mind. You just get Dixie over here quick.
She's not going to listen to me. I'm a felon.
Well, you just tell her that it's a red alert.
What the hell?
Now, scat! Go, Stanley, go!
All right. Come on.
Hello? Hello, is Sheriff Gibbons there? Yes, put him on. Hello, Sheriff, this is Pearl Burris. I'm calling to report a theft. 4 of my Rhode Island Reds have gone missing. I just woke up this morning and they were gone. You don't suppose the Christmas Phantom could have anything to do with it? You ought to drive by here more often. I am a taxpayer, and those hens are my livelihood. You don't have time? I understand. You would make time if the Phantom stole your rubber sheets. Oh, God, they're back. I see you. I'm coming for you. I'm coming like a storm.
Pearl! Why'd you send that slobbering hippie over to my house?
Now, Dixie, don't distract me. This model has that Blue Jay's name on it.
No. Oh, just a nose hair off. you want to kill a bird, you gotta think like a bird. Sing to him, Pearl.
I've never heard of anybody singing to a blue jay.
You damn sure never killed one, neither.
Well, I hope they like the Andrews sisters. Down in the meadow, an itty bitty pool swam three little fishes and a mama fishy too.
Swim, said the mama fishy, swim if you can. So they swam and they swam right over the...
Damn! Oh,
just missed him.
He'll get the word out.
Maybe you should sing something more contemporary, Pearl.
Dixie!
Oh, God!
I just remembered, Dixie. Oh. You can't cut the lights off on the play, you just can't.
Says who?
My nephew, Stanley, has to be in that darn fool play to finish his probation.
Sit down, Pearl, sit down.
If he doesn't get off, it'll just ruin Christmas for all of us. And Rubber Sheets is watching him like a hawk. One wrong move and he's a goner.
I'd like to help you, Pearl, I would. But I can't. If I let that little theater off on their light bill, every light bill in town will go unpaid.
I know that.
That's revenue, Pearl. That's how we pay for our stop signs and our do not litter signs. And if that money dries up, then the traffic will get all snarled. And the litter will pile up till you're knee high in garbage and hot rodders. And then your insurance rates will go sky high, sky goddamn high.
Yes, Bob.
Filth and disrespect breed crime, Pearl. And that draws in gambling. And the mafia. And then before you know it, we'll have pari-mutuel betting, liquor by the drink, parallel parking on Sundays. We won't even be able to park for all the goddamn whiskey bottles. And then before you can say scat, communists will come pouring across the Rio Grande, and that'll be the end of civilization as we know it.
But all I'm asking...
No buts. If Stanley wants to get off probation, he can come down to the welfare office and lick stamps for me. I'm not turning over my town to Fidel Castro, and that's that. Oh, look, he's back! Sing, Pearl, sing!
Don't sit under the apple tree with anyone else but me. With anyone else but... Oh, you dirty bird, you!
Maybe you should sing some Lionel Richie.
Dixie!
Oh, you did it again!
Oh, I'm sorry, Dixie, but I just remembered we're in trouble. We are in big, big trouble. Meanie Bird's been babbling. She told Dee Dee that the three of us are the Christmas Phantom.
She has to shut up. She has to shut up, or we'll all be wearing striped pajamas. Oh. This is all your fault, Pearl. I told you she'd be the first one to crack. She nearly got us all caught back in 32.
Now we gotta be calm. You're too damn old to be peering out between jail bars.
Don't stick that finger in my face.
Damn you!
I know karate! I know karate!
Rubber Sheets! Oh. Sit down, Daisy. Wave to him. We're waiting.
Hello.
Oh, we're just sitting here being old ladies.
We're super old.
Lord, I think we're safe. Oh. Who's gonna believe a little old lady like Mimi with cake coloring in her hair?
She looks like death chewing on a cracker. Well, the heat'll be on now. We won't be able to be the Christmas Phantom anymore, and that's always been my favorite part of Christmas. Our party's over.
Our bubble's burst.
It's our last waltz.
It's the end of the line.
Adios, amigo.
Sayonara.
22 skidoo.
Good night, Irene.
Good night, Irene.
Good night, Irene. I'll see you in the...
Oh, he's back. Quick, give me a slingshot. There's a yellow rose in Texas, the finest ever grew. Her eyes are bright as diamonds, they sparkle like the dew. You can talk about your family time.
Oh, bingo!
We got him!
Good shot, Dixie! We'll have him stuffed by Stanley.
Ah, squawk now, you loudmouth!
Oh. You know, Dixie, I've been thinking, it's not like the Christmas Phantom just to up and quit because some little old lady with egg dye in her hair and one foot in the grave starts babbling.
It would seem suspicious at that.
Well, if the Phantom is down to his last prank,
I haven't seen that look in your eyes since you snatched the toupee off the faith healer in Wichita Falls.
Oh, he claimed to heal the sick and he couldn't even grow hair?
Ah.
Now, we gotta put our thinking caps on, Dixie. Only the best yard will do. She's had it coming for 15 years.
Oh, she's back! She's back! Here. You sing.
You can talk about your Clementine, the thing of Rosalie, but the yellow.